Cramer's rule allows us to find the solution of a linear system using determinants. But why do we want to do that? We can use row reduction. Indeed, row reduction is more efficient than Cramer's rule, in most cases. There are two exceptions though. Two cases in which Cramer's rule is more convenient than row reduction. First of all, Cramer's rule allows you to determine the unknowns one by one. So if you need only one of the unknowns, Cramer will be fast. Second, and more importantly, and this is how I used it myself, sometimes your coefficient matrix contains unknown parameters. In that case, row reduction is very cumbersome and Cramer is still quite doable. So, especially in the second case, Cramer is used a lot. So, how does this rule work and why does it work like that? That is what you will learn in this video. So, what is the situation? We have an n by n matrix A and we want to solve Ax is B. Then first we form the matrix AIB. How do we do that? We keep the first I minus one columns of A the same and then we replace the ith column by B and leave the rest the same. So it's easy to form this matrix. Just replace one of the columns of A by your unknown vector B. And then once we have done that, we can compute the xi, the ith unknown, straight away by the quotient of two determinants, determinant of AIB divided by the determinant of A. So using this rule, you can find straight away your xi by just computing two determinants. Now, why does it work like this? We will form first to see why it works like this. We will first form an auxiliary matrix IIX, which is the identity matrix, where we replace the ith column by the vector with unknowns x. So what do? We have as first column e1 and then e2 and so on up till ei minus 1. Then we put the vector x containing all unknowns and then we go on. Now this determinant of IIX is actually pretty easy. So how does the matrix look? A lot of zeros and only once on the diagonal, once on the diagonal, and here you have your column with unknown x's. However, it is easy to compute this determinant. We can use row reduction steps. And using row reduction, we can get rid of the x1 by using this ith row. You can form a zero instead of the x1, you can get rid of the x2, and so on and so forth. You can eliminate all variables in the column and you're only left with an xi and zeros above and below it. And now computing the determinant is easy. It's just 1 times 1 times 1, product of the numbers of the on the diagonal, times xi times 1 times 1 times 1, or just xi. So the determinant of a matrix IIX is just xi. How does this help us? Well, if we compute A times IIX, so what do we have? We have A and II was E1 up to E2, E3 up to X, and then EI plus 1 up to EN. Use the definition of matrix times matrix. This yields A times E1, A times E2, and so on. A times E1 equals A1, A times E2 equals A2, and so on. And the A times X over here gives you exactly B. So what do you get? A matrix with columns A1, A2, and then the ith column is B, and then we get AI plus 1, etc. up till AN. So what you get is exactly your matrix AIB. So our product A times IIX gives us exactly our AIB. Now, how does that help us? Now we're almost done. Now we compute determinants on left and right. The determinant of A times IIX equals that AB equals that A times that B. So that equals that A times that IIX. And it is equal to our determinant of AIB. And now we can solve the determinant of IIx was xi. So we have xi times determinant of A equals determinant AIB over here. And we can solve for xi. There we go, xi equals that AIB over that A. So there we have our formula for xi. So that is Cramer's rule. Using just two determinants, you can compute immediately one of the unknowns of your problem Ax equals B.